Hey there, it's Dr. Bernstein, the president and founder of Get Yourself Into College. I work with a lot of students applying to undergraduate engineering programs. So in today's video, I want to provide you with a bunch of really valuable tips that can help you more effectively prepare for these programs if you're in 9th, 10th, or 11th grade, and how you can more effectively position yourself for these programs if you're a senior and you're applying to college. And along the way, I will be sharing some important insights from UPenn, Cornell, Rose-Hulman, and Columbia. So stay tuned. When admissions officers are reviewing applications from potential engineering students, they are also looking for evidence of your ability to collaborate. They're looking for your ability to effectively problem solve. They are looking for evidence of your capacity for systematic thinking. They're looking for details about your adaptability and what a Tufts admissions officer calls the ability to survive under tough circumstances. Why? Well, these are habits of mind and ways of being that are essential to your success within engineering programs and, of course, are important for future engineers. Cultivating these qualities is one thing. You also have to make sure, in a tactful way, that other people are aware that you possess these qualities. If you're a senior, you are going to want the teachers who are writing your letters of recommendation to be able to describe how they see these qualities manifesting in your work, in your projects. And of course, they cannot write about these things if they don't have evidence of it. So just handing in a project, just getting an A isn't enough. They need to know more about your process. You might even want to write your Common App essay or your main application essay on something related to collaboration, like an experience you had collaborating with your peers. Or you might want to write about an experience you've had solving a particular problem. I want to dig a little bit deeper into this issue of problem solving in relationship to engineering. I was reading an article in one of the January 2016 issues of the Chronicle of Higher Education, and in this article, the author was talking about how universities nationwide are attempting to teach undergraduates to think more broadly and aggressively about how they can help solve real-world problems. So these are engineering programs that are trying to do this. In this article, the author talks about the Grand Challenges course that is offered at Rose-Hulman Institute of Technology. This course assigns students a specific place in the world and asks them to research the local population and figure out a technology that might help them. Students in this course have designed filters to clean water in Kenya. They've invented a process for converting plastic trash into roofing tiles in Haiti. The University of Pennsylvania points out that when reviewing applications to the School of Engineering and Applied Science, they're looking for students with an ability to innovate, design, and practically apply scientific discoveries. And in their supplemental essay, Cornell asks you to describe an engineering idea you have or about your interest in engineering. So if you're in 9th, 10th, or 11th grade, I want you to start thinking about, like, what kind of engineering breakthroughs do you find exciting? What kind of problems do you hope to solve through engineering? You might even want to start trying to figure out how you might go about solving these problems. You might not be able to actually solve them now, but you could map out some possible ways of solving these problems. If you're in 12th grade and you're already applying to engineering programs, you might already have a sense of what aspects of engineering interest you, what kind of breakthroughs excite you, what kind of problems you want to solve. But if you don't, that's okay too. So one thing that I want you to do is look at what the faculty and students at the schools, the engineering programs that you're applying to, what they're doing. So sometimes you can find student projects. It's usually easier to find faculty profiles and see what kind of projects they're working on, look at their CVs, their curriculum vitae. And this way, instead of just like waiting and hoping for an idea to somehow descend from the sky and come into your mind, you're actually looking at what people at your schools are doing. And that can help you get clear about like, I definitely don't want to do that, or wow, I'm intrigued by that. And yes, it does take a bit of time to do this research, but the ROI, the return on your investment, is quite high, because most engineering programs, especially good ones, are going to ask you to write a supplemental essay that explains why you want to pursue engineering at their particular institution. Cornell's supplemental essay, for instance, also asks you to describe how your ideas and interests may be realized and linked to specific resources within the College of Engineering. And they want you to explain what a Cornell engineering education will enable you to accomplish. The University of Pennsylvania asks you a similar question, and you kind of also have to do that for your application for Columbia's engineering school. We've really just scratched the surface in this video, and I have so much more information that I want to share with you. If you want to learn more about how to successfully apply to engineering programs at Tufts, at Princeton, MIT, Stanford, and University of Pennsylvania, and more, head over to my website. The link to that blog post is in the description box below this video. You could also just Google how to successfully apply to engineering programs and get yourself into college, and that blog post should just pop right up. That's it for now. I hope you have a great day. Take care. Bye.